quiet guest right off the bat. I'm going to be at the helm here for the next couple of hours, and I think Claire will take over a little bit later on this afternoon. But so glad that you're here on a Saturday. We're glad that you've joined us. And as you know, we are the rebellious voice of Texas Liberty. We take that very seriously. So it seems like this is a pretty rebellious crowd here. And we've been hearing from, so far this morning, there was an appearance by Congressman Louie Gohmert. This is his first back in his beloved state after the speaker election vote in Washington, D.C. And I really wanted to get some feedback from a friend of his. And so Lydia is from the Beaumont area, right? And what Tea Party are you with?
I'm with the Southeast Texas Tea Party.
Okay, well, welcome to Raging Elephants Radio for the first time. And folks, I just want to tell you that once again, I'm sitting across from a bombshell. This lady is beautiful. All right, so I was telling our listeners that we had an appearance with Congressman Louie Gohmert this morning. And I've known him, of course, before. I saw a different Louie today than what I have become used to in the past, but you know him as well, Lydia, and I wanted to get your thoughts on what happened this morning, because he wasn't allowed to speak right away. And he kind of got a little bit tricked. Okay.
I guess there's always that hope that others will step up and join you in what you're trying to accomplish.
Well, there was an opportunity since he was back in town for the first time since the speaker's vote. This organization, Tea Party Patriots, really wanted to honor him. Now, this was not because he jumped into the speaker's race. This was planned months ago. People wanted to honor him because they value the character with which he conducts himself in Washington, D.C. This is the true Texan representative that we all desire, that we all, you know, are looking for. It's what we try. That's right. That's right. Sadly so, and unfortunately so. And so before he was kind of brought up on the stage, but they didn't introduce him yet. And they said, we'd like to honor you, Congressman Gohmert, and he was really taken aback, because he thought he was here to deliver, you know, kind of anchor the address, the keynote speaker, which is, you know, it's work. You know, it's work. And so they had a big plush red chair for him and asked him to be seated, and then a few people were able to get up and honor him, and I wanted to get your feedback on that.
I think he really did a great job in talking about what he liked, not only representing what kind of a man, his character, what goes on behind just that public he did explain to us.
Yes, he did.
That he's uncomfortable with compliments, and that his wife has encouraged him to say thank you. As always, he does. And he did have the opportunity to share with us what the behind the scenes and to elaborate on what the special to some of the what we see on the internet, remarks,
The first speaker that honored him was Jeff Siddiqui, and he brought, what he had done was he went to people who knew Louis and asked for some personal anecdotes. I knew that I was the second speaker, and I really had something prepared to tear into what I'm calling the Tynos, the Texans in the public, which is the Texas delegation that so let us all down. We know that they heard from us, Lydia. We know that they heard, they had a clear directive to not vote for Boehner. They had a clear directive. There is not one Republican congressman in the Texas delegation who can claim, I had no idea.
Every time.
Yes. That's right.
Because if you'll put in where their district office's email, it will allow you to go under their email, even if you're not from their district.
Mm-hmm.
I think I should be able to
you should.
Contact any congressman.
That's right.
Anywhere. So I actually.
Because their idiocy affects us all.
Exactly.
That's
exactly.
Right.
And so, and I talked with other people who were calling and contacting them. And so we really provided them, if you please, with a cover.
Yes.
For saying, this is what our constituents want.
The people have spoken.
Exactly.
Yes, everybody was working overtime. We had very little time, but everybody mobilized instantaneously.
Yes.
So we know that the Texas delegation, specifically the Republicans, had their marching orders. And what I'm hearing back now is that there is some anger and retribution for Gohmert standing up and forcing them to have to make a decision and a choice for giving them a choice. See, they don't want to have a choice. They just want to. They want to take the easy route and say, "Well, there was no one else running, and so unanimous acclaim, blah blah blah." We know that's how they operate in Austin too. And so, when my opportunity came to speak. My gut instinct was I really wanted to rip into those Tynos, those Texans in names only, for throwing Louis under the bus and then attacking him, kicking him, and not doing what their constituents wanted, because the way I saw it, Lydia, is that these guys, these Texans, were more loyal. They demonstrated more loyalty to that orange invertebrate out of Ohio than they did to their own Texan constituents. They said basically, well, I've heard from all these guys, they don't count. My loyalty, my vote goes to Boehner. And so I thought, okay, I really want to have this opportunity. That would have been easy, low-hanging fruit. But this moment had to be about Louis. This had to be about affirming every effort that he's made over the years, because this is not his first stand. This is not the first stand that he's made either alone or with very few standing with him. And so I really wanted to just ignore the Texans that had perpetrated this crime on a fellow Texan, which is what I'd consider that to be a betrayal. And so I really just wanted to focus exclusively on him in a positive and uplifting way. I hope I accomplished that.
You certainly did.
Oh, thank you.
I really believe that at this point, one of the comments that Jeff gave was one that I had on Amazon. The Saddle of Texas events.
I was there, yeah.
You had several folks.
Yes. Yes.
And pay their lip service of all those men, of all those congressmen who are still in office.
Right.
Only Louis Gohmert has maintained his integrity and followed through with what he said he would do that day. And you know, really, his other partners should be thanking him for the opportunity to get to vote against one that they know is doing our job. The recommendation has proven his inability to lead and the kind of childishness that in a major corporation.
And what was interesting today.